गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। सो वी विल वेट फॉर अ मिनट टू अदर्स टू जॉइन देन वी विल स्टार्ट। सो मीनवाइल
ओके सर।
कीप योर अटेंडेंस, जस्ट आई एम शेयरिंग एलएमएस पोर्टल। So what we are discussing yesterday, so can anyone? Yes, what is operating system? Someone define for me what you understand by operating system. Yes.
A software that is interface between the user and the hardware.
Okay, so we need to use system software. Okay, it is not only software, but it is system software. There is difference between a software, application software, and system software. If I say software, then it include application software as well as system software. Fine. Operating system is system software. Why it is system software? Because it is used by the system, not by the user. Now user is not using that one. Okay. Whatever thing yes. is performed, it is performed by the systems. See, operating system जो है system software है. जो उसका primary काम क्या है? Primary काम है आपका interface provide करना user और hardware के बीच में. Fine. Then we discuss it can be viewed in three format. It is act as a resource allocator. So whatever resources we are having, either hardware resources or software resources, so it will be managed all the resources. Second, it will control the programs. What are the programs are executing or ready to execute, or all the things are controlled by the operating system, and it manages the kernel. Now kernel is one who directly interact with the hardware with the help of सिस्टम कॉल. ठीक है, कर्नल ही आपका एक मेन वो है जो आपका डायरेक्टली इंटरेक्ट करता है किसके साथ, इट विल इंटरेक्ट विद योर हार्डवेयर डायरेक्टली विद द हेल्प ऑफ सिस्टम कॉल. ठीक है, देन वी डिस्कस आर्किटेक्चर व्यू और एब्स्ट्रैक्ट व्यू ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. इफ यू रिमेंबर बेसिकली एंड वन मोर थिंग रिगार्डिंग ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, इट्स ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड प्लेटफॉर्म. ठीक है, इट ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड द प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर एग्जीक्यूट अदर एप्लीकेशन सॉफ्टवेयर. सो वॉट एवर अदर एप्लीकेशन सॉफ्टवेयर वी आर हैविंग, ओके, वॉट एवर अदर एप्लीकेशन सॉफ्टवेयर वी आर हैविंग, इट विल प्रोवाइड द प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर देम. ठीक है, टू एक्सेस लाइक योर वर्ड प्रोसेसर, या फिर आपका नोट पैड हो गया, या फिर एनी मल्टी मीडिया प्लेयर हो गया, टू प्रोसेस दैट वन द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम ऑनली प्रोवाइड द प्लेटफॉर्म. तो अगर हम लोग आर्किटेक्चर व्यू देखेंगे, यू सी द आर्किटेक्चर व्यू ऑफ इट ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. सो हाउ इट इज लुक लाइक, सो इट हायर लेवल व्हाट आर देयर. सो वी आर हैविंग द एंड यूजर्स व्हिच डायरेक्टली इंटरैक्ट विद द एप्लीकेशन सॉफ्टवेयर्स. ओके, नाउ दिस एप्लीकेशन सॉफ्टवेयर विल कम्युनिकेट विद ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. नाउ दिस ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम टेक हेल्प ऑफ कर्नल एंड सिस्टम कॉल्स टू इंटरैक्ट विद द हार्डवेयर. to interact with the hardware to get the final output. So this is the architecture view, abstract view of an operating system, how it is providing an interface between user and hardware. Fine, तो यहाँ पे हम लोग डिस्कस किए थे कल कल डिस्कस किए थे. Now next question is what apart from this three things. First क्या था आपका interface between user and hardware. Second था आपका it will provide act as a resource manager. And third one it will provide a platform for executing application software. तो इन तीनों को छोड़कर और क्या functionality provide करता है ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. इन तीन चीजों को छोड़कर और क्या क्या कर सकता है ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. यस
सर, प्रोवाइड सिक्योरिटी.
ओके फाइन, प्रोवाइड द सिक्योरिटी एंड प्रोटेक्शन.
टाइम मैनेजमेंट. सो फाइल मैनेजमेंट.
यस, व्हाटएवर फाइल वी आर क्रिएटिंग, okay, or whatever file we are deleting, it is all managed by the operating system. ठीक है. और next और क्या करता है?
Device management
for the user.
Sorry, फिर से बोलिए एक बार.
Hide the details of the hardware resources from the user.
Okay, hide the hardware details of the user. Okay, we can say device management. Or we can say device management. Process, so whatever device we are having, yeah, whatever device we are having. So for example, suppose how the mouse is working. User are only moving the mouse. But हम लोग क्या देखते हैं? Mouse का जो pointer है आपका screen में इधर उधर scroll होता है. Or it will be moving there. अगर हम लोग यहाँ पे move कर रहे हैं mouse को तो वहाँ पर scroll move हो रहा है. Now it is actually happening. Now we are managing the device. User is not managing device. आपको लग रहा है आप move कर रहे हो रहा है. Now it is not managed by the user. It is managed basically it is managed by the operating system with the help of some device drivers. Yes, there are some device driver के बारे में सुने थे ना? To access any hardware, we need a device driver, which is nothing as set of APIs system. APIs बोलते हैं application program interfaces are there. So this APIs will generate a system call to perform an activity. Okay, for time we will not discuss that one. So just remember it is used for device management. Anything else? Process management. Someone said process management. So process management means, so whatever process we are going to create or delete. Okay, all this thing, creating a process, deleting a process, or assigning a process.
Allocation and deallocation of the CPU.
Or allocation and deallocation to the CPU. Again, how the process will communicate, how the process to synchronize. Okay, all these things. Or what resources the process are required to complete the task. Okay, the process requires some resources. It may be a hardware resources. Okay, so how these resources could be allocated. Okay, on what priority basis you will allocate the resources. So all these things. Okay, all the concern regarding the process. इस प्रोसेस क्रिएशन से प्रोसेस के टास्क को कंप्लीट करने तक जितने भी चीजें प्रोसेस को चाहिए वो आपका ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम ही प्रोवाइड करता है. फाइन, एनीथिंग एल्स. सो वी हैव प्रोसेस मैनेजमेंट, वी हैव प्रोटेक्शन एंड सिक्योरिटी, वी हैव डिवाइस मैनेजमेंट. एनीथिंग एल्स
सर? मेमोरी मैनेजमेंट.
यस, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. अगेन नाउ it is used for operating system is again responsible for memory management. Memory in terms of basically we will talk about primary memory and secondary memory. Okay, how this memory, because the memory is very vital here. Memory is very vital here. So how we will manage the memory. Fine. Okay, now there is one more thing, disk management. We bolte hain disk management basically deals with your secondary memory management से deal होता है. Now these are the functionality you have to remember, because sometimes they ask this question, what is operating system, then what are the functionality they are providing. So we can see here in the next slide. So what are the functionality we have provided? So we are already, I think already discussed this thing. So process management we have discussed. So process management nothing but process creation से process deletion तक जितने भी काम होगा all the things are managed by the operating system. Similarly, memory management in terms of main memory and secondary memory management बोलते हैं, how to manage the memory, that means which process to allocate which block of memory, and when the process is deallocated, how to delete the process, ठीक है, all that thing related. We will discuss each and every more thing in details, okay? हर चीज को डिटेल में हम लोग पढ़ेंगे. Then device management. Now device management basically deals with your input output devices that we are having. So all the input output devices that we are having, that should be managed by the operating system. Then the file management, whatever file we are having in our system, are again managed by the operating system. Then protection and security. Protection and security deals with your internal protection as well as protection from outside. Okay, so that someone internal protection, like an unauthorized user cannot access your computer. Like we provide a password security protection. है कि नहीं? तो क्या होता है? What happened here? When you provide a password security protection, so unauthorized user cannot access your system. So this is called protection. And security deals with unwanted function or software cannot enter to your system. It will perform with the help of firewalls. Yeah, every Windows operating systems come with some firewalls. The firewalls provide to unwanted software to enter in your system. Okay, now so it is also used for control over system performance. Okay, so system performance is again is a part of process management. So how will control the program process so that the system performance can be maximized. Okay, system performance can be maximized. Job counting. What do you mean by job counting here? Now, job counting basically deals with user log. Okay, user log se deal karta hai. Means how many users are logged in for particular time and what are the resources they are used, what are the files they are used. Okay, so basically, if I say job counting, the job counting is basically related to the user details or user log का डिटेल्स के बारे में होते हैं, ठीक है? Like time that spent in the operating system में कितने time वो user ने access किया था, क्या-क्या file access किया था, what are the process they are access, everything you can manage by the operating system. Then like error detection, again whatever problem you face, it is detected by the operating system only, ठीक है? Then control input and output devices. Then it also coordinates with other software users. Now other application software that we are having, it provides a platform for them to execute. Okay? So these are some functionality that are provided by operating system. Okay, so if they ask in exam, agar poochte, now we have to explain each and everything in details. Fine, clear? It is clear. What are the functionality?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So don't worry about it. क्योंकि हर एक functionality के बारे में हम लोग detail में पढ़ेंगे. At least for process management, memory management, device management, file management, security, and one more thing, disk management is not there. Disk management. Okay. At least we discuss this thing in detail. How operating system used to manage this thing. Fine. So before going to the further, so let me explain how actually it is working. Yeah. So what happens? So whenever we suppose I write a program, okay. Just concentrate here. I'm going to explain something. So suppose I write a program. Suppose this is C program I've written. C program ko hum likh rahe hain. Okay. Now this is C program. So where I can write my C program? So where I can write my program? So I need some editor. Yes or no? Editor or IDE chahiye. Okay, I need some editor or some IDE. Fine. So in case of writing a C program, so I will use the editor. Now once I finish this writing, so जब मैं इसको once I write the program, so next हम लोग क्या करते हैं, I will save this file. So once I save this file, so what will happen? Now what will happen? Now once I save this file, now what will happen? Now this C program are stored in a secondary memory. ठीक है? आपका ये जो C program है, now it will store some file name sort. Suppose the file name is abc. Dot c. Dot c is extension of file. Okay. As says, man, it is clear. So what is happening? So whenever we write the C program, any program, C program, any program in editor, once I finish writing, what I have to do? I will store this file. So whenever I store this file, कहाँ पर store होगा वो? It will store in a secondary memory. Then what I will do? I will start compiling. I will use the compiler. In this case, I will use the C compiler. I will use the C compiler to compile it. Okay. So when you start compiling it, what will happen? What will happen? Now, what will happen? This program ABC, this program ABC is moved from secondary memory to main memory or primary memory बोलते हैं. ठीक है? कहाँ पे shift हो गया है? अभी आपका ये shift हो गया. ABC dot C कहाँ पे shift हो गया? आपका main memory में shift हो गया. Right. Now once you compile it, what will give? There is a no error. So it will be from and dot exe file. Now which can be executable. ठीक है? Now which can be executable. Fine. Now once this file is ready to execute, so what I will do? Now I will submit this file to the operating system. Okay. Submit this file to operating system. My operating system will assign CPU for this program. Okay. Operating system will assign this program abc.ex executable file to the CPU. Now CPU execute and gives us output. Okay, now CPU execute and gives an output. Now this will be in running mode. This will be in running mode. Fine. So this is the process how any program are getting executed. So first you have to write in editor. Once your editor write and compile it. Once you compile it, then it will be in execute mode. Now the OS will try get a system call to execute it. Once it is executed, it will assign a CPU. Okay. Once the CPU finishes execution, it will provide an output. Provide an output. Okay. Now what actually happening here? Now there are only two things we are having. Now whatever data we required, whatever data we required, or whatever program that main memory से वो CPU में load होता है. Now whenever the process is required, CPU will communicate with the main memory. Okay, or I can say whenever the CPU is ideal, जब कभी भी CPU ideal होगा, then what will happen? It will ask for new process from the main memory. So whatever process will there in main memory will transfer to the CPU. Here, fine. How it is executing? How any program is executing? And how operating system are helping to execute the program. Fine. So you have to remember this: the CPU is interacting with the main memory for the new process. Okay. So let's move to the next topic, which is your different types of operating system. Okay, or I say evolution of an operating system. Okay. So what do you mean by evolution here? So whatever evolution, so we will not discuss evolution in terms of kal jo hum log lab mein padhte like Windows version 1 version 2 version 3, not in terms of that. Now we will talk evolution in terms of generalized operating system. Fine. Generalized operating system. So, सबसे पहले earlier we are having an operating system, something called batch operating system, which is designed in 1970s. Fine. So we are discussing evolution of operating system with respect to how the operating systems features are changes in terms of their computing. Okay, in terms of their computing speed. The first jo operating system tha, that is called batch operating system, which is designed in 1970, where the process or jobs are assigned in terms of batches. Now batches will be assigned to the CPU. We'll discuss this one. The next is a multi-programming system, then your time sharing system, then multi-processor systems, distributed system, and real-time system. There are many more. Advanced operating systems are there, which is used, but we will limit our discussion to this six type different types of operating system. Okay. So let us discuss the first operating system, which is called batch operating system. Okay. So one thing you have to remember in batch operating system, what happening here? Now jobs are now one thing jatna. In our this lecture, we will use job and process are both are same thing. Okay. Job and process both are same thing. तो इन टर्म्स ऑफ बैच में हम लोग बोलेंगे प्रोसेस को जॉब. बैच में हम लोग क्या बोलेंगे? बैच ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम में प्रोसेस आर नोन एज जॉब, बट इन अदर थिंग्स वी कैन से प्रोसेस. ठीक है, और प्रोग्राम सम टाइम वी कैन से प्रोग्राम आल्सो. सो व्हाट हैपेंड हियर, नाउ वी हैव अ सेट ऑफ जॉब्स लाइक J1, J2, J3, like that up to JN. So what happened now? Ek cheez yaad rakhna, now we have only one CPU in our system. What we are having? We are having only one CPU. At any instant of time, for any instant of time, only one job can be assigned to the CPU. Fine, is it clear? कोई भी इंस्टेंट ऑफ टाइम है, कोई भी इंस्टेंट ऑफ टाइम में एक ही जॉब या फिर एक ही प्रोसेस सीपीयू को असाइन हो सकता है. सीपीयू कैन नॉट परफॉर्म मोर देन वन जॉब एट अ टाइम और मोर देन वन प्रोसेस एट अ टाइम. सो एनी इंस्टेंट ऑफ टाइम सीपीयू विल असाइन वन जॉब एट अ टाइम. सो व्हाट हैपनिंग इन द बैच ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, सो एनी जॉब और प्रोसेस रिक्वायर टू थिंग्स. ठीक है, to complete the tasks of any job or tasks of any process, they require two things. One is CPU time, one is called your CPU time, and second is called your input output time. Kya bolte hain? Input output time. Input output time. Fine. For example, suppose I have to perform some calculation, then I have to take a printout of that document. So what will happen? The time spent for the calculation is called CPU time, and taking the printout from the printer, it is called input output time. Okay. Or sometimes they require some additional files to perform the calculation, that is also called input output time. Fine. So kehne ka matlab hai koi bhi job ya koi bhi process hoga aapka, so entire throughout the life cycle they invest the most of the time either in CPU for the computation purpose or they spend their time in input output events. Okay, for the input output events to perform some task. Okay, now what are the batch processing system say? Until one job is finished, this task, we cannot assign a new job even though the CPU is ideal. Okay, suppose now what happened? I assign Now what happens? Suppose J1 is assigned to the CPU. J1 assigned to CPU. Now what will happen? Suppose I assume that J1, total time required for J1 is suppose 100 milliseconds. Suppose if it required 100 milliseconds. Now in this 100 milliseconds, suppose it is required only 5 milliseconds for CPU time and 95 milliseconds for input output time. ठीक है, input output time. Fine. So what will happen? So once it is once the computation part. मतलब now what will happen for job J1? Now job J1 will be perform only 5 milliseconds in the CPU. That means for the 95 second the CPU will be ideal. For in this case, for the 95 second the CPU will be ideal. Okay. Now what will happen? Even though CPU is ideal, we cannot assign new job to the CPU. Okay. Clear. So what will happen? Now one thing you remember. There, whenever you designing an operating system, the CPU utilization should be maximized. So CPU should be used in such a way that it should not remain ideal for long amount of time. ठीक है, तो job batch processing में क्या होता है, एक job जब भी assign होगा CPU को, ठीक है, तब तक कब तक assign होगा, जब तक वो अपने tasks complete नहीं कर लेता, whether it is the CPU time or it is the input output time. Okay, so what will happen now? What is the drawback of this type? Now drawback of this type is the CPU will be ideal for longer amount of time, even though it's not using, we cannot access. Fine. So what can we do? Now there will be OS. We have here operating system here. Now operating system will assign these jobs. Okay, so one thing we can do now, we can assign these jobs in batches. So what I will do, so jobs with similar activity, like if job one is a C programming, job three is also a C programming, so I will create these two jobs in one batch so that they require same or similar files or similar input output event. So I will create a batches. So batch one, batch two. Similarly, batch two I will create. Suppose this is your Java programming, okay? Or one more function, Java programming. That means based on the similarity of the jobs, okay? Based on the similarity of jobs, I will create a different batches. Okay. Now 6, 7, 8 batches man. Now batch man. Now what will happen? So instead of assigning single jobs, so I will assign a batch here. Now batch will be like T. Okay. Now here also, again we cannot assign both the job at the same time. Okay. Dono job assign nahi kar sakte same time. Either you have to assign CPU to job one, then once job one will finish, job three will be assigned to the CPU. Now how the time is reduced? Now the input output time, the time required for input output are same for the both the cases. So it does not require to allocate new force file for the job one and job two. So somehow it will reduce. It reduce karega kyunki dono ko same source of इनपुट आउटपुट इवेंट चाहिए था, तो इट विल बी नॉट रिक्वायर्ड, क्योंकि नया फाइल आपको लोड करने में वो टाइम आपका बच जाएगा. और दिस इज कॉल्ड समथिंग बैच प्रोसेसिंग. ओके, नाउ व्हाटएवर जॉब्स वी आर हैविंग, एक्चुअली क्या होता है, जॉब आर कलेक्टेड इन टर्म्स ऑफ बैचेस, जॉब्स आर फॉर्म्ड इन टर्म्स ऑफ बैचेस. नाउ दिस बैचेस आर असाइंड टू द मेमोरी. ठीक है, मेमोरी. नाउ मेमोरीज आर इन दैट टाइम वी आर कॉल्ड कंट्रोल यूनिट बोलते थे. ठीक है, और कार्ड, सम कार्ड रीडर्स आर यूज टू स्टोर द जॉब्स. ओके, कार्ड रीडर्स आर यूज टू स्टोर द जॉब्स. नाउ दिस जॉब्स आर असाइंड वन बाय वन. सो व्हाट इज द ड्रॉबैक हियर, सीपीयू एफिशिएंसी इज वेरी bad. Efficiency of the system is very bad because the CPU will be ideal for longer amount of time. Fine. Now, to overcome this one, we introduce the concept of multi-programming. Okay, which is the second evolution in operating system. ठीक है, second evolution operating system हुआ क्या बोले हम लोग, multi-programming environment. So what is multi-programming environment? Now you have to make sure that the CPU will not be ideal. Okay, CPU will not be ideal for longer amount of time. So what we have done here in multi-programming concept. So in multi-programming concept, so instead of assigning a single job in main memory, so what I will do? I will assign different jobs in main memory. Job 2, job 6, job 9, and job 10. Okay, now this part is my main memory where your different jobs are assigned. Now this part is my main memory. This is my CPU. Okay, so what will be the multi-programming? Now I know that any job are required 2 times, which is called CPU time, and there is some time required called input output time. Fine. So, multi-programming environment में क्या हुआ? Suppose J1 initially CPU is ideal. हम लोगों ने J1 को assign किया कहाँ पर? CPU में. अब J1 में कितना था? 5 amount of time था आपका CPU time और 95 amount of time था आपका क्या था? Input output time. ठीक है. तो अब जब हम लोगों ने J1 को assign किया after 5 amount of time, मतलब जब J1 will finish this CPU time, okay, we will simply remove the J1 from the CPU. So what we have done, we will remove the J1 from the CPU and place in a block state to perform its input output event. ठीक है, लेकिन J1 अभी तक complete नहीं हुआ, remember this thing, J1 just finished its input output time. And we are placed somewhere, we store somewhere else. Okay, we are stored somewhere else. Basically, we store in registers. Okay, CPU register to perform its other tasks like input-output time. Okay, so what happened? Once it is removed, now CPU will be ideal. So I will assign one more job to the CPU. Okay, now what I will do? I will assign job 2. Now suppose job 2 required 50 milliseconds. Out of which 20 millisecond it used for CPU time and 25 millisecond used for input output time. Okay, now what will happen? Now job 2 will be in CPU. So what is happening here? So at any instant of time, what you will see for the user point of view, a user will see, user kya bolega? Now there is a two jobs are running. One is J1, which is your performing input output task, and there is a job 2 which is performing your CPU task. So what we have done, now we are performing multiple program. Okay, or multiple programs are executing. Lekin yahan par ek cheez aapko yaad rakhna hai, actually kya ho raha hai, at any instant of time only one job, this is very important. किसी भी मोमेंट में ओनली वन जॉब कैन बी असाइन इफ एनी प्रोसेस और एनी जॉब इज एक्सेसिंग द सीपीयू वी कैनॉट असाइन अनदर जॉब टू इट. ठीक है, व्हेन वी कैन असाइन अनदर जॉब, व्हेन द सीपीयू इज आइडियल. जब आपका सीपीयू आइडियल होगा उसी केस में आप क्या कर सकते हो, आप नया जॉब को असाइन करोगे. ठीक है, so whenever one job finish its CPU time, okay, I will just remove this job or switch off करेंगे और what term is there, context switch. Okay, we will perform a context switch to job 1. and placed in a somewhere called register to perform its input output task. Okay. So what happened? So then the CPU will be ideal. I will assign one more job to it. So what actually is providing? Now it is providing a multi-programming environment. Okay, now this is a very revolution. So now what we are achieved by performing multi-programming process, the CPU efficiency are increased. Okay, the CPU efficiency are increased. जो भी आपका सीपीयू यूटिलाइजेशन था या फिर सीपीयू का एफिशिएंसी था इंक्रीज हो गया. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ द थ्रूपुट ऑफ द सिस्टम. थ्रूपुट मींस नंबर ऑफ प्रोसेस कंप्लीटेड पर अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम. नाउ इन दिस केस बैच प्रोसेसिंग में क्या था, नंबर ऑफ प्रोसेस पर अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम बहुत लेस था बिकॉज़ द सीपीयू विल बी आइडियल फॉर लॉन्गर अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम इवन दो इट इज नॉट एक्सेसिंग. लेकिन अभी यहाँ पर क्या हुआ, आपका जो आइडियल टाइम था सीपीयू का वो रेड्यूस हो गया. किस केस में? मल्टी प्रोग्रामिंग एनवायरनमेंट में. इज इट क्लियर?
यस सर.
यस सर.
सो और इन सिंपल वी कैन डिफाइन व्हाट इज मल्टी प्रोग्रामिंग. व्हाट इज मल्टी प्रोग्रामिंग? इज नथिंग बट सेवरल जॉब्स आर केप्ट इन मेन मेमोरी. ठीक है, एक से ज्यादा जॉब या प्रोसेस आपका मेन मेमोरी में रहेगा. एंड व्हेनेवर द सीपीयू इज आइडियल, ओके, व्हेनेवर द सीपीयू इज आइडियल द जॉब्स आर असाइन्ड. और आई कैन से द जॉब्स आर मल्टीप्लेक्स्ड. द जॉब्स आर मल्टीप्लेक्स विद द सीपीयू. ठीक है, द जॉब्स आर मल्टीप्लेक्स विद द स्विच. द जॉब्स आर स्विच विद द सीपीयू. लेकिन एक चीज आपको याद रखना है, कभी भी सीपीयू में एक से ज्यादा जॉब एग्जीक्यूट नहीं होगा. मतलब एक टाइम में जॉब J1 भी सीपीयू को यूज कर रहा है, जॉब J2 भी यूज कर रहा है. दिस इज नॉट पॉसिबल. ओके, दिस इज नॉट पॉसिबल. एक्चुअली क्या करता है, मल्टी प्रोग्रामिंग एनवायरनमेंट में एक ही जॉब यूज होता है. लेकिन फॉर द यूजर पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू क्या होता है, यूजर को क्या लगता है, दो प्रोग्राम या दो जॉब पैरेलली रन हो रहे हैं. नो डाउट दोनों प्रोग्राम रन हो रहे हैं, लेकिन एक आपका क्या है, एक आपका इनपुट आउटपुट इवेंट कर रहा है, दूसरा आपका सीपीयू एक्सेस कर रहा है. फाइन. और आज के डेट में जो भी ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम है, देयर आर ऑल मल्टी प्रोग्रामिंग. ओके, देयर आर मल्टी प्रोग्रामिंग. फाइन, क्लियर? एंड हाउ मल्टी प्रोग्रामिंग कैन बी अचीव? इट इज अचीव बाय स्विच, कॉन्टेक्स्ट स्विच. कॉन्टेक्स्ट स्विच बोलते हैं, कॉन्टेक्स्ट स्विच मेथड. कॉन्टेक्स्ट स्विचिंग बोलते हैं या स्विच मेथड बोलते हैं. कॉन्टेक्स्ट स्विच मतलब जब कोई भी जॉब या प्रोसेस सीपीयू को यूज नहीं कर रहा है, देन आई विल सिंपली मेक अ कॉन्टेक्स्ट स्विच. दैट मींस जॉब J1 इज रिमूव एंड न्यू जॉब इज असाइन टू द सीपीयू. सो आई विल टेक, देयर इज 1 मिनट फॉर दिस क्लास. सो वंस द टाइम इज ओवर do join after 10 minutes. Okay, after 10 minutes same link mein aapko join karna hai. Fine, then we will discuss the rest of the thing. So any question I will take, any questions regarding this two types of operating system, batch operating system and multi-program. So major difference is in batch operating system only one job is inside the main memory. Okay, aur jab tak जॉब फिनिशेस इस टास्क, जब तक जॉब आपका टास्क कंप्लीट नहीं करता है.